On behalf of the Ministry of Lectors, Commentators, and Psalmists, we would like to extend our deepest gratitude for your exceptional leadership and guidance during your 6.5 years in our parish. Your impact on our ministry has been profound, and we will always cherish the lessons we have learned under your tutelage. Your inspiring homilies have left us in awe and touched our hearts in countless ways. Through your words, you have imparted wisdom, love, and faith, motivating us to grow as individuals and strengthen our commitment to our ministry. Your unique way of delivering the Word of God has truly captivated our attention and deepened understanding of the Scriptures. We also want to express our appreciation for your attention to detail and your willingness to help us improve in our service. Your unmistakable expressions and discerning eyes have kept us on our toes, encouraging us to be more attentive and dedicated in our role as lectors, commentators, and psalmists. Your constant guidance has played a crucial role in sharpening our skills and ensuring that we provide the best possible proclamation of God's Word. As you prepare to embark on a new journey, we want you to know that your impact will not be forgotten. The lessons we have learned under your leadership will continue to resonate with us, guiding us in our ministry and in our lives. Furthermore, we are inspired by our minimalist approach to leadership, which has taught us the value of simplicity, humility, and focusing on what truly matters. Thank you, Father John, for your unwavering dedication, love, and guidance. Your presence in our parish has been a true blessing, and we are grateful for the opportunity to have worked alongside you. As you move forward, may your future endeavors be filled with God's grace and continued inspiration to lead and touch the lives of others. With heartfelt appreciation and best wishes from the MLCP family.
Hi, Father John. I wish to express my thanks to you for being our pastor, for guiding all of us the past several years, lalong-lalo na po in the most difficult years of the COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you for all your homilies. I'm sure not only me, but lahat po kami, we're all inspired by those homilies which are truly God's messages, God's inspiration to all of us through you. So maraming salamat, Father. Secondly, I wanted to also express my thanks to you for being God's instrument. And I'd like to honor you again for this, for being God's instrument in calling me to serve Him in our parish, in His church, in the church that we all love so very, very much. I would also want to lift up my prayer to our Lord for Him to continue to protect you and guide you as you move forward with your priestly vocation. It is my prayer, Father, that you will again also be God's instrument in calling other people to serve Him in His church, and also God's instrument in inspiring them to do the work of the Lord through the church. Let me end this message, Father, with a short prayer for blessings for you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look kindly toward you and give you peace. Amen.
Good morning, Father John. For the past years that you have been with the BEC, Basic Ecclesial Community, since before the pandemic, although it is a struggle, as you heard, you have done your best effort that your parishioners may obtain the capability of embracing the innermost changes, siempre from the deepest portion of our hearts, to be a better person today than yesterday. You taught us to be grateful always to God, who is a good provider, and be generous to others, especially those in need. As a newly appointed BEC head coordinator with the BEC community, we feel sad sa pag-alaala ng mga nakaraang kaganapan bago pa nagka-pandemic, lalong-lalo na ang Misa to Mesa kung saan imbitado ang lahat ng mga BEC mula sa iba't ibang lugar upang dumalo sa Eucharistic celebration. Ang iba ay may mga bit-bit na pagkain sa abot ng kanilang makakaya upang pagsasalo-saluhan pagkatapos ng Misa sa fellowship time. And it is only in fellowship time whereby some of the important agenda are opened. To restore the Misa to Mesa quarterly is one of our plans for this year, 2024. We do hope that through the guidance of the Holy Spirit within you, wherever place you may be assigned, there is the guiding light that may brighten your way facing your journey towards divine will. We thank you, and we will surely miss you.
A very good morning, Father. This is Remy. I will read the message for Compare because this is only for 3 months, which started this January. But before I read to you or express to you our message, may I first tell you that on behalf of myself personally, and I'm sure other parishioners would agree that your homilies were very nice, they were meaningful, and they were very instructive. In short, your homilies were short, sweet, again, and very substantive. And now I read to you our heartfelt message. On behalf of the catechists from Padre Pio Parish and Compare family, we would like to express our deepest gratitude for your exceptional leadership and unwavering support over the past 6.5 years. As you begin a new chapter in your journey, we bid you farewell, but with a mix of nostalgia and heartfelt appreciation. Father, throughout your tenure, your guidance has been very invaluable to us. You've consistently encouraged and supported our activities in Compare, allowing us to reach out to the various communities and serve those in need. Your dedication in organizing a yearly First Communion and confirmation rites has helped nurture the spiritual growth of our young members. Moreover, Father, the monthly Children's Mass that you introduced has created a sense of belongingness and joy among our youngest parishioners. Your commitment to involving and engaging them in our worship has had a profound impact on our and their faith development. We are especially grateful for your openness to feedback, which has guided us to become better catechists. Your thoughtful insights and constructive criticism have challenged us to grow personally and professionally. Your generosity in sharing your wisdom and experiences has undoubtedly made us more compassionate and effective in our roles. Father, as we say goodbye, we want to convey our warmest wishes for your next assignment. May this new chapter in your life be filled with abundant blessings, joy, and fulfillment. Know that you will be deeply missed, and the Padre Pio Parish will always hold a special place for you within our hearts. Thank you, Father John, for your unwavering love, dedication, and leadership. The impact you have made in our lives and the lives of countless members of our community is definitely immeasurable. We carry your teachings, guidance, and compassion with us as we continue to serve and express God's love. With utmost gratitude, Compare. In Jesus we pray for joy, peace, and to have good health in your new assignment. See you again, Father. Thank you.
Listen, baby. Dear Father John, we would like to thank you for all your support extended to Knights of Columbus, Padre Pio Parish, Council 15139. You have been with us on our project, installation of officers, and other affairs in the country for the past 6 years. We are so grateful and thankful for endorsing the council to use the same fields of Petrosina, Father Pio Paris, to be our council. Thank you also for your guidance and prayers. And moreover, thank you for giving us a place where the PLC members can hold its meeting, its education and other council activities. Good luck, Father John, on your new parish assignment.
Giving us your 6.5 years of dedicated priestly service. Thank you for the beautiful and meaningful homilies and mass celebrations. I hope those will be part of your memorable journey. Father, my and Bernie's full service to church has been very significant under your leadership and guidance because one of our dreams ay nangyari na. So, we have a beautiful church in our community, and I think that's your legacy. So, thank you, Father. And as you prepare for your transfer, Father, I pray for your good health, peace and joy, and happiness. So, I hope this is not goodbye kasi I think and I hope na mag-celebrate ka pa naman ng mass dito sa Pagipio. So, Father, may God bless you and keep you strong in your vocations. So, thank you, Father.
Good morning, Father John and all the community from beautiful Hong Kong. And personally, and on behalf of my family, who actually are in London these days, just wanted to give you thank you, big, big thank you for everything that you have done for the community of St. Pio Parish. And also, we want to wish you the very, very best, the most fruitful tenure at your new parish. I'm sure that the Lord has prepared that our paths cross again. We thank Him for giving us the opportunity and the privilege to know you. And we pray for you, your family, and all your new parish, as well as St. Pio. Bye-bye. See you soon.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us welcome the new year with the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.